who would hear your personal accounts with breast cancer and not think of their survivors as more than conquerors. I'm the facilitator, and I was so moved by your stories that I must say, I too will breast cancer.
I've never seen her before. Oh, that chemotherapy broke me down. That bucket list narrowed down to three things. To live, of course. To be alone when I wanted to be alone. And to simply drive my car around the block. Doctor increased my chemo pill. They made me sick, so he stopped there. I'm just taking one pill today. Last week, after an MRI and a CT scan, the doctor found fluid around my heart and lungs. Well, I'm scheduled for an echocardiogram tomorrow. Don't know how that's going to turn out, but I know that God is with me, as always. Oh, but Lord, I'm so tired of being tired and helpless. I can't do anything. I can't drive my car. I miss my car. I used to get in my car and drive with no place in mind. Sometimes I just go wide open down 40 with the air just blowing in my face. I'm going to call my doctor tomorrow and find out when I can drive my car again. Yes, Lord, now that's what I'm going to do. I need to feel my foot on that pedal, my hands on that steering wheel, and just slowing down fairly enough to round the corner. Ah, Lord, that's freedom.
Thank you.
So, my story could have been so much worse. And yes, I had my moments of despondency, but I had many more moments of encouragement. My daughter was a constant source of motivation, and I didn't want to leave her. I wanted to make every game. I wanted to hear about every life experience. So all I knew how to do was to fight. After that experience at the clinic, I refused to leave any facility without speaking to a doctor. I researched the type of chemotherapy and radiation and dialogued with doctors as if I was a medical student. I raised my voice loud enough for every doctor in the triad to hear. Whew, and hearing and seeing my daughter graduate was well worth it all. And in the end, giving a breath for a life, that wasn't so bad at all.